Warning, do not retire to the Philippines. And I'll give you 10 reasons why you shouldn't. And I also have a bonus reason at the end. Hey everybody, I'm Mike.
And I'm Chanip.
And welcome to our channel, Mike's Philippine Retirement. Now let's get to today's video. If you're addicted to alcohol, drugs, or gambling, you should not come to the Philippines. And the reason I'm doing this video is because what I saw last night. Janet and I were driving home from a friend's house. Some bloggers were there. We had a nice Sunday afternoon together. And then we were headed into town to go have dinner. And along the side of the road, in the dark, definitely a foreigner, I don't know if he was American or British or whatever, totally drunk walking along the side of the road. I almost hit him. I'm amazed he's not dead. Didn't see any reports of this. If you're an alcoholic, if you're addicted to drugs, or you got a severe gambling problem, the Philippines is not the place for you. Alcohol is too easy to get, and the consequences of dealing in drugs, illegal drugs in this country, jail is not nice here. So you definitely don't want to be an alcoholic or addicted to drugs in the Philippines. Don't come to the Philippines if you don't have any savings. Don't be that guy who's at back home in the States trying to scrape together another 20 bucks to pay for the plane ticket. If you don't have savings, don't come. If you don't have savings, work a little bit longer. Work another year, another 2 years. Make sure you have some savings before you come here. Just because you can scrape together the plane ticket and you have 1 month's budget doesn't mean you're going to come here and have a good time. You're doing nothing but looking for trouble. So if you don't have any savings, don't come to the Philippines. Don't come to the Philippines if you've never spent any time here. If you've never come here for an extended vacation, 30 days, 60 days, 90 days, don't commit to living here. Don't just get on a plane and say, I'm going to live in the Philippines for the rest of my life. Too many foreigners come here, but they've never been here in the Philippines. They've never experienced the hot weather. They've never experienced the rainy season. They haven't experienced the food. Make sure that you have been here for an extended period of time before you commit to living in the Philippines full time. Now, if you come here to the Philippines for 2 weeks or a month's vacation, you meet a girlfriend, you meet someone like Janet, and you have the best sex ever, you're having a great time traveling around with her, you know, going down to the beach, just loving life. You know, life has never been better while you're here on your vacation. And you go back home thinking, I'm gonna go ahead and sell everything, and I'm gonna move to the Philippines and have a great life. In that 2 weeks or that month that you were here, you know, it was a fast-paced vacation. You were having a great time. You really weren't living in the Philippines. You were living in a vacation atmosphere. You were going to restaurants, you were going to bars, you were going to the beach, you were going wherever you were going, and you were having a good time and you were having great sex. When you get back home, if you decide you want to come and live in the Philippines, come here for an extended period of time before you sell everything. Don't sell your house. Don't sell everything to come here and make that total commitment unless you spent an extended period of time here in the Philippines. I hope you guys take a moment to like this video and leave a comment below. Let me know what you think about these 10 different reasons for not coming to the Philippines. If you're a foreigner and you like to complain, and you come here to the Philippines, don't come here. Don't come here and be a complainer. Don't be that guy sitting at the bar, having a beer every night, and complaining about everything that went on around him. Complaining about the jeepneys being too small. Complaining about no turn signals on some of the motorbikes. Complaining about 5 people on a motorbike. Kids without helmets. No traffic signs. No stop signs. No red lights. If you're coming here to complain, nobody really wants to hear it. It's okay to have a friend and vent once in a while, But don't come to the Philippines if all you're going to do is complain about the way of life here. Don't come to the Philippines if you don't have an income. You know, if you're lucky enough to have $30,000 squirreled away, or $50,000 and you're 50, 45, and you think, I'm going to come here to the Philippines and I'm going to be tight with my money, I'm going to make it last until Social Security kicks in or your pension kicks in, you have another thing to think about. Everybody on my channel has heard Paul, Old Dog, New Tricks, and his story with John. No matter how much money you have, it's going to go quickly if you have no influx of cash. If you don't have an income coming in, that money's going to go fast. All it takes is one bad investment, one bad loan, one emergency, one trip to the hospital, and it gets small fast. It goes away fast. And there's nothing worse than being stuck in the Philippines and being broke. Don't come to the Philippines if you don't have patience. When you're here, you need to have patience. The way of life here is slower pace. It may seem hectic in the streets with the traffic, like everybody's in a hurry to get somewhere. They're really not in a hurry. They're basically traveling pretty slow. And when you go to the grocery store and it's time to check out and you got three or four items, it could be a long wait. They're not that fast. Everything goes in slow motion. Takes a long time sometimes in the bank. You might have to play musical chairs where you sit in a chair and the next person gets waited on, then everybody gets up and they move over one chair and they sit down. That could take some time. You have to have patience. When you go to a restaurant for food, your date might get served first and your meal is going to come 10 minutes later. You have to have patience here in the Philippines. Don't come to the Philippines if you're picky about your food. Now, it's good to be picky in a way, but if you're coming here thinking you're going to get a bunch of organic vegetables because you saw the Valencia Farmers Market or the Bacon Market or the market in downtown Dumaguete where they have vegetables laid out everywhere, they use a lot of pesticides on their foods. And the chicken and the fish, it might not be the freshest meat that you've ever had. Can't be picky about the food. Be selective. When you go to a restaurant, the food might be good one day, they fire the cook and it's terrible the next. The food here isn't the best food in the world. It's good food. I like it. Janet likes it, of course. But if you're picky about food and you're going to complain about food not being of the quality it is back home, don't come here. Don't come to the Philippines if you don't like animal noise. You know, I had somebody look at one of my videos. It was a house for rent, 35,000 pesos, $700. Beautiful house, three or four bedrooms, couple bathrooms in a compound, grass in Valencia. Very nice house, very well built, good furniture. And he got there and he said the reason he didn't take it, he heard a dog bark. Dogs bark everywhere. I'm doing this video in between the dogs barking. And roosters. They're everywhere. They love their roosters here. Some guys, I saw one YouTuber tell me he's seen people, they would feed the rooster before they would feed their family. The chickens, they're everywhere, but everybody knows whose chickens whose. And us, we have turkeys next door. There's a dozen turkeys that gobble gobble every morning and are very loud. If you don't like the animal noise, like some of my comments say, if I can hear a dog, if I can hear a rooster, I'm not going to live there. And also the noise of karaoke. A lot of people say they don't like the karaoke noise. The Filipinos love the karaoke. They'll sing it for hours and hours when they have a party. They'll spend a lot of money renting the karaoke machine, and they'll have fun playing it. If you don't like karaoke, you don't like dog noise, you don't like roosters, I don't think the Philippines is the place for you. If you have a medical condition, and this medical condition is being paid for by Medicare, or an insurance policy back in the States. Think hard before you come here. I don't want to tell somebody with a condition that they shouldn't come to the Philippines. I don't know how you think about your life. Do you want to spend it here in the Philippines with the condition and live with it? That's up to you. But Medicare does not pay any bills out here for you. You can't get treated under Medicare. You're going to have to pay for your own medical treatment. And any kind of insurance that you get out here, it's a pre-existing condition, and they won't cover it. So you're going to have to be self-insured. So if you have a severe medical condition, think really hard. Don't come here. Stay in the States where your insurance is paying for it, and you can get treatment and enjoy a good quality of life. If you're sick here in the Philippines, it can be a miserable life here. If you don't have family here, you don't have friends here to take care of you, it's not going to be good. If you don't have emergency funds, if you don't have money for an emergency, and I wasn't talking about the savings from earlier, this is money that you need to get to in case of an emergency. You break a leg, you have a heart attack, you need to go to the hospital. Even if you have your Medicare and you say, I'll go back to the States for treatment, an emergency happens here, you're not taking a plane with a heart attack to the States. You have to go to the hospital here and get taken care of. You break a leg, you get in a motorcycle accident, you get in a car accident, you have to go to the hospital here, and you need money for that. You need funds. Have emergency funds, have access to money, and have more than one way to get money. You never know what's going to happen. You never know when you need to get out of Dodge. You've got to leave the island. You piss somebody off. You need to move. Have emergency money. Maybe that girlfriend you've been fooling around with is married and the husband's pissed. I don't know. But have funds to get out of town, get on a plane, get out of here. Have funds to go to the hospital and get yourself taken care of. Now, I hope you like this video. I hope you subscribe to our channel. Leave me a comment below. Are these reasons any good for not coming here? Let me know. Now, the bonus reason, don't come here. Don't come to the Philippines. Don't retire to the Philippines. Do not retire to the Philippines unless you have an exit plan. You have a plan to leave the Philippines and go back home. You could be here 2 years, 3 years, 5 years. Something goes bad. You get some disease and you need to go home and get it taken care of. You just hate it here. You know, you and the girlfriend break up and you just can't stand living in the Philippines anymore. You need a plan of how you're going to get out of here. People always tell me, what are you going to do if China invades Taiwan or the Philippines? Well, do you have an exit plan just in case of that? Have a plan to get out of town. Have access to your money to get that plane ticket. How are you going to get out of town? And when you get back to your home country, where are you going to stay? Have a plan. What city are you going to go to? Have a plan. Have a plan A and a plan B. I want to thank everybody for watching this video. I hope it was helpful. Until next time, thanks for watching. Like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe. Don't forget to click the button's bell. Bye-bye, guys.
Hit the notification bell, guys. What do you think of that one? I'm always yelling at the camera. Don't come. I think that was okay.